Hello and welcome to the COVID classroom. I'm Chetan Sharma. This is a space where we sit and take lessons and learnings from what has been and shall remain, unfortunately for a while, a very unique situation, a very unique calamity, and a very unique pandemic. We've talked about three E's on the channel, which are very critical to this situation. E number one is enforcement, E number two is essentials, and E number three is engagement. Enforcement is the jurisdiction of the government, as well as us as citizens, to maintain the lockdown. Essentials, by and large, is, again, at the behest of the government. They've got to ensure through logistics that essentials reaches each and every citizen of this country. We, of course, as journalists, play a role and try to ensure that they do, that everybody gets what is due to him and required by him at the right place at the right time. But this is the space for the 30, the E, which is engagement. An engagement particularly to the largest and the younger section of society. As we all know that as India grows older and the world grows older, India grows younger. Our mean age continues to get younger and younger, which means that the population, which is sub 35 or even sub 25, right, are the ones we try to reach out in this particular program. And the reason for doing that is because this is the strata which is getting educated by the day, but also has a high amount of pent-up energy which needs to be channelized constructively when there's destruction all around us. Joining me today on this very special show is the person who's at the helm of education in this country, Anil Shastrabuddhi, the chairman of AICTE. Thank you, sir, for joining us on this very special program. The last time I spoke to you was when you were, you know, the chair of honor at our education conclave in December. That's the time I remember that you had spoken about a new India, a new vision, a new world led through the realms of education. Obviously, you hadn't seen things changing so fast. Dr. Shastrabuddhi.
Hello. Good morning to all of you.
So tell us, sir, what are the first thing that hit you when this calamity hit all of us? And how have you step by step through the realms of education sought to address every challenge? And several of them would have come your way.
So this is a big calamity. Not only India is facing, but the entire globe. The seriousness of this was not there in many countries, and that's why from December, January onwards till March, there have been more than 20,000 deaths and more than 5 lakh people affected. Thankfully, so far so good in India, the numbers are quite low, and unless we take precautionary measures and be alert about how it spreads and how we have to have social distancing to be maintained, I think we will have a challenging time. And fortunately, the government has taken several initiatives in order to educate people as well as provide required succor and support to the needy and the poor.
Right. Now, let's come to the very critical strata that we all, well, we face at home and you face in the schools and across the entire education fraternity, is the youth. Now, this is a unique situation because despite all that's happening around us, on the positive side, we've come together as a far more connected world. We've also come together as a far more collective world. But what we need to also become is a very constructive world. The best way to counter destruction is through construction. So what is your first message to, you know, the lakhs of students around us? How do they conserve their energy and then make it constructive?
See, we are all a connected world and we continue to be so. Today, connection need not be, fortunately, a physical connection by coming together in large numbers, but the connection can be over internet, over various, you know, modalities that are possible by having education online, whether it is through MOOCs, whether it is through engagement through platforms like TCS, ION. I think we have plenty of technologies available today to reach out to each other and be connected, learn by each other, and still not be physically in intimacy at a distance of more than 2 meters, thereby spread of this coronavirus does not take place.
Okay, so what are the challenges that you've been facing thus far in time in your attempt to make this a far more connected India than what it was?
The challenges are people have to realize that there are technologies available and they need to use them. One of the challenges some students do mention is they are in some remote areas where the connectivity is as not good as in some of the towns and cities. Maybe some of them will face certainly some difficulties. But today, fortunately, internet fiber connectivity has reached nooks and corners, including the remote northeast, rural areas, tribal areas. Maybe speed is not as fast as that it is there in some of the major cities, but they can still get connected. Secondly, all these platforms are not necessarily only online live, but one can download some of those educational contents and watch them offline into their respective computers and laptops. And so I think connection is possible in different ways, and we must make use of all possible means so that our learning does not stop, our actions do not stop, and we move forward facing the crisis in a very constructive and positive way.
You know, good sir, we often say that we spend all our life learning. Every single day is a new lesson for all of us, provided we take it. Not too many of us do. You know, we allow egos to come in front, you know, which in front of us. So that's the time when we stop learning. But while we do believe formally that education is the prerogative of the young, I'm sure that you'll be experiencing it's also a prerogative of the teachers, not just of the students, because a lot of them find themselves challenged in this digital environment, particularly in the case of virtual classrooms. And I've spoken to a few of them, and the schools have been trying to initiate this process, and several of them have, actually. But it's the stumbling block is not the student. The student is far more flexible. He is connected. He is connected even outside his classroom. So he understands the digital medium far better than the teachers. Perhaps that's a bigger problem on hand.
Chetan Sharmaji, you're absolutely on the dot. In fact, the real challenge is in terms of educating our teachers, changing their way of teaching learning processes and so on. And that is why, fortunately, much before this coronavirus attack happened, AICT on its part in the last 1.5 years has been working out on what is known as a mandatory teacher certification program. It's an 8-module program starting with passion for teaching, technology, and so on to whatever we call it as the examination reforms, the entire life cycle of the teacher, how do you interact, how do you use virtual classrooms, ICT. All of these are part of these 8 modules. And this has been made mandatory that unless one goes through this, he will not become a regular faculty member. He has to remain contract or ad hoc faculty member. And this has been already launched much before, as I said, the breakout of the virus corona. And I'm very happy that 4 NITERs, National Institutes of Technical Teachers Training Research Institutes,